We all know that our country's journey toward equality is not finished yet. We know it right here in this room. It's been 5 years since Lawrence versus Texas and 39 years since Stonewall, but still, we've got work to do before we achieve equality in the LGBT community. He's also spoken out against the stigma surrounding HIV testing, which is still plaguing so many of our communities, which you all know a lot of that is due to homophobia. Barack has led by example. When we took our trip to Africa and visited his home country in Kenya, we took a public HIV test for the very point of showing folks in Kenya that there is nothing to be embarrassed about in getting tested. And we did it as a couple. And he said something very simple. He said, all too often we settle for the world as it is, because we think it's the best that we can do, even if it, when it doesn't reflect our values and aspirations as a nation. We all have felt that. It won't change. We can't do anything any differently. This is the best we can do. We're blessed. Maybe we shouldn't ask for more. We've all said that at some point in time in our lives. But Barack reminded us on that day that we also know what the world should look like. And I'm here because I know I've lived with this man for 20 years, and I say this all the time, he has not let me down once. He has spent his entire life trying to build the career based on that struggle to narrow the gaps. And wherever he has a chance, he uses his God-given talents to move that bar. That's what he did all those years ago, working in churches, helping families build better lives. And it's what he did when he turned down a big law firm to become a civil rights attorney all those years ago. And that's what he did as a state senator before entering the U.S. Senate. He was a champion of the law that amended the Illinois Human Rights Act in our state to prohibit discrimination on the basis of sexual orientation and gender identity in the workplace. In the world as it should be, we can work together to repeal laws like DOMA and Don't Ask and Don't Tell. And we can oppose. We can oppose divisive constitutional amendments that would strip civil rights and benefits away from LGBT Americans, because discrimination has no place in a nation founded on the promise of equality.
Well, listen, we want to congratulate you on Barack Obama, our new president, and you must be very proud.
We are.
Yes.
We really are. We're also proud of the U.S. For having made history as well.
Hey, one more quick question. Our President-elect Obama's birthplace over in Kenya, is that going to be a national spot to go visit where he was born?
It's already an attraction. His paternal grandmother is still alive, and
but his birthplace, they'll put up a marker there.
It will depend on the government. It's already well known.
Do you know the Barack Obama, his father's name is it Barack Hussein Obama Senior? Is that true? Do you know?
Well, I know him as Barack Obama.
Okay.
And he served in the government. He served in the government. He actually served with our current president, who is also an economist. Mm-hmm. Both of them were well trained. Our current president is a graduate of the London School of Economics, and Barack Senior was an economist from Harvard.
Really?
And so these were the first Kenyan graduates of the 60s, that came back to build our nation.
Yeah. Wow. Yeah. Well, listen, sir, thank you very much for the time. We just wanted to check in, given the proceedings that have occurred, a great historical moment. And thank you, Your Excellency, for your time.
Well, thank you so very much, guys, for your excitement and for congratulating us.
Absolutely. Well, thank you very much. You have a nice day.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Okay, bye-bye.
Did you catch that?
Not a lot of it.
Mike, he basically admitted that President-elect Obama was born there.
Yes, he did.
That's what I was asking him. Remember the controversy about...
About Hawaii and whether he naturalized or not, or what happened.
I mean, that's a fact.
No, you're going to have to replay it, because I didn't...
I asked him if there was going to be a marker
that he was born there.
And I said, President-elect, not to confuse with his dad. And he said, absolutely, there's already plans.
Right, so there you go. So that means we're going to have to remove his, we're going to have to undo it.
I'm not going to argue with His Excellency. If he says President-elect Obama was born in Kenya, he was born in Kenya.
It's disrespectful to argue with him.
The candidate's close family members are not watching in New England or in Texas, but from here in the west of Kenya. Said Obama is the presidential hopeful's uncle. He's been watching his famous nephew's progress from the town of Kisumu. Another Obama still living in the village is Barack's grandmother, known as Mama Sarah. Senator Obama has been back only a few times. Even so, there's a strong attachment between the two of them.
Barack and Nyati Dalani. Barack and Nyati Dalani. Barack and Nyati Dalani. Kata muso pinjongi mana kata meno kono. Owachana dani adi tadi yo timo dwaro komeduo. Omitsa.